さ。無静なイエス救いむさ。
여러분 안녕하십니까?
Hello everyone.
예, 우간다를 사랑하시는 그 하나님으로 오늘 영광을 돌립니다.
I glorify God for loving Uganda.
예, 오늘은 1월 1일입니다.
Today is the 1st of January.
2024년이 3년이 밝았습니다.
And now the day of year 2023 has become brightened.
그동안에 2022년 어려웠고 또 걱정되고 슬픈 거 이제 다 뒤로 돌리시고
And so all the difficulties and the sadness and the problems that you had in the year 2022 now you just let it by.
2023년도 이제 하나님 우간다에 이곳에 계시는 성도분들에게 시청자들에게 하나님께서 축복하실 줄 믿습니다.
I believe that God is going to bless our people of Uganda and also the viewers in the year 2023.
저는 한국에서 왔습니다.
I come from South Korea.
한국은 지금 아주 추운 겨울인데요.
Right now Korea is a very cold winter.
제가 비행기가 눈이 많이 와서 2시간을 늦게 출발했습니다.
In Korea it snowed a lot. That's why there was 2 hours of delay in airplane.
영하 10도까지 내려갔는데요.
And the temperature went down minus 10 degrees.
근데 제가 우간다의 캄팔라에 도착했을 때
And but when I arrived in Uganda Kampala
도시가 너무 날씨가 좋았습니다.
And the weather was so good.
우간다는 복받은 나라입니다.
And truly Uganda is a blessed country.
1년의 날씨를 보면 너무 날씨가 좋은 거예요. 거예요.
And so when you look at the weather of Uganda one year along, the weather is so nice.
한국은 겨울이 추운 겨울이 4개월이나 있습니다.
And so in Korea we have a very cold winter for 4 months.
그리고 우간다는 땅이 너무 넓고 또 땅이 너무 비옥한 겁니다.
And also the Uganda, the land is so vast and very fertile.
여러분들은 하나님께 감사드려야 돼요.
And you should actually thank the Lord.
우리 한국은 우간다보다 땅도 3분의 1밖에 안 되고요.
South Korea, the land is only the size of 1/3 of Uganda.
또 거기에다가 산이 70%나 됩니다.
In that small land, 70% of the land is the mountain.
거기는 집도 지을 수가 없고 공당도 지을 수, 학교도 지을 수가 없고요.
You cannot build a school, you cannot build a factory, you cannot build anything there.
그리고 농사도 지을 수가 없는 거예요.
And you can't also do farming on that land.
근데 이 우간다는 너무 땅이 좋습니다.
And, but then Uganda, the land is so fertile and good.
또 우간다 국민 하나님께 감사해야 돼요.
And also the people of Uganda, you should thank the Lord.
물이 얼마나 많은 나라입니까?
And this is a country with plenty of water.
깨끗한 물을 마음껏 마시고 마음껏 사용할 수 있는 게 얼마나 큰 복인지 모릅니다.
You can freely drink the water and use the water, and that's a great blessings.
우리 한국은 물도 부족한 나라입니다.
Korea is also a country with lack of water.
그에 비해서 우간다는 모든 걸 다 가진 아름다운 나라인 것 같습니다.
And compared to that, Uganda is a country that has all the beautiful things.
저는 오늘 이 UBC의 구경 박정국의 신년 말씀을 전하는 부분에 대해서 하나님께 기도를 했습니다.
And so I prayed before God before I was preaching and delivering the New Year's message on the UBC.
하나님, 우간다에 있는 당신을 사랑하는 자녀들에게 오늘 신년에 어떤 말씀을 하나님 전하기를 원하십니까?
God, to your loving children in Uganda, which New Year message do you want to give unto them?
아, 하나님께서 우간다에 요셉이 17살 때의 꿈을 꾸었던 것처럼 우간다 사람들에게 꿈에 관한 이야기를 해라 말씀하셨습니다.
And then God, he spoke to me as Joseph at the age of 17, God has given him a dream. Also speak about the dream to the people of Uganda.
그가 꿈을 꾸고 많은 어려움이 있었습니다.
He had a dream and after that he had a lot of difficulties.
꿈으로 인해서 도리어 형님들에게 미움을 받아서 이집트로 노예로 팔렸습니다.
Because of the dream he was hated by his brothers and then he was sold to Egypt as a slave.
그러나 중요한 것은 요셉에게 꿈이 있었습니다.
And but important thing is so Joseph he had a dream.
그리고 꿈을 생각했습니다.
And he thought about the dream that he had.
나는 노예로 팔렸지만
I am sold as a slave.
나는 앞으로 치리자가 되고 총리가 되고 왕이 될 사람이야.
I am the one who is going to be the overseer, the prime minister. I'm going to be the king.
이건 내가 꾼 꿈이 아니라 하나님 꾸게 하신 꿈이야.
And this is not my own dream. This is a dream that God gave me.
그 꿈이 요셉에게 큰 힘이 되었습니다.
And that dream became a big strength into Joseph.
그리고 창세기 39장에 보면은 바로 왕의 시위 대장 보디발의 집에 종으로 팔렸습니다.
And so now Joseph in Genesis chapter 39 he was sold as a slave in the Potiphar's house.
자, 거기에서도 여러 가지 어려움들이 있었지만 요셉은 어려움을 이길 수 있었습니다.
And again there he had a lot of difficulties but he was able to overcome all that difficulties.
그리고는 바로와 바로의 그 시위 대장 보디발의 아내의 유혹을 당하는 어려움을 당했습니다.
And then he also had the difficulties of receiving the temptation from the wife of Potiphar's wife.
그래서 성경은 우리들에게 이런 이야기를 합니다.
And so the Bible is telling us like this.
요셉은 무성한 가지 곧 샘 곁에 가지라 했습니다.
And so Joseph is like the branch with abundance and next to the river.
담을 넘었도다 하는 말이 있습니다.
And it has gone over the wall.
그 창세기 49장 22절의 말씀인데요.
And that is Genesis chapter 49 verse 22.
요셉은 무성한 가지라 곧 샘 곁에 무성한 가지라 그 가지가 담을 넘었도다 했습니다.
And so, you know, Joseph he was a branch and that branch has gone over the wall.
그는 샘 곁에 가지였습니다.
And so it was the branch next to the river.
그 샘은 바로 예수 그리스도를 가리키고 있습니다.
And now you know that water is talking about Jesus Christ.
시편 1편에 물가에 심겨진 나무에 대한 이야기를 하는데 역시 물가 예수님을 가리키고 있습니다.
And also in the book of Psalms is talking about the water. That water is the shadow image of Jesus Christ.
그리고 예레미야 17장에서도 물가에 심겨진 나무 했을 때 그 물가도 예수님을 가리키고 말씀을 가리키고 있습니다.
And also in the book of Jeremiah it is talking about the tree that is planted next to the water. That water is also the shadow shadow image of Jesus Christ.
요셉이 어려움이 있었지만
Joseph had difficulties.
그러나 샘 곁에 가지기 때문에
And but he's the branch next to the water.
이길 수 있었습니다.
He was able to overcome it.
더위가 올지라도
And though the heat may come.
걱정이 없습니다.
He doesn't have any problem.
많은 열매를 맺을 수밖에 없죠.
He cannot help but bear many fruits.
그는 요셉이 꿈을 꾸게 하신 하나님과 연결되어 있는 힘이죠.
And that is the power which he is connected together with God who made him to have a dream.
그 다음에 23절에 보면 활 쏘는 자가 그를 학대하며 그를 쏘며 그를 군박하였으나
And verse 23 says, the archers have bitterly grieved him, shot at him, and hated him.
요셉의 형님들이 미움의 화살을 쏘아댔죠.
And so the brothers of Joseph shot the arrows of hate.
보디발의 아내가 유혹의 화살을 쏘았죠.
Potiphar's wife shot the arrows of temptation.
그러나 그걸 다 이길 수 있었던 것은요.
And, but the reason why he was able to overcome all of that.
요셉이 꾼 꿈을 생각하고 했습니다.
And because Joseph remembered the dream that he had.
그리고 24절에 요셉의 활이 돌이요 경강하며 그의 팔이 힘이 있었다 했습니다.
And then verse 24 it says, but his bow remained in strength and the arms of his hands were made strong.
어려움과 고난과 역경과 힘드는 것은 도리어 우리 그리스도인들에게는 힘이 되고 능력이 될 수 있습니다.
The difficulties, problems, tribulations and sufferings to Christians, those are going to be the strength into our life.
여러분, 코이라는 물고기가 있는데요.
Everyone, there is a fish called koi.
아, 이 코이 물고기 아주 신비한 물고기입니다.
And this koi fish is amazing fish.
이 코이 fish는 어항 안에 두면은 그 크기가 지금 화면에 보는 것처럼 저 정도예요.
And so if you put this koi fish in the fish bowl as you see from the screen, that's the only size that it can grow up to.
어항 안에서는 저게 다 자란 거예요.
And so that is the full size inside the bowl.
그런데 어느 날 저 물고기를 연못으로 옮겼습니다.
But one day they moved this fish into the pond.
아, 그런데 다섯 배나 커지게 되었습니다.
But then it grew 5 times bigger than that.
깜짝 놀랐죠.
And then we were surprised.
근데 이 물고기 다시 큰 강물로 옮겼더니
And again we moved that fish to the river.
20배까지 커지는 겁니다.
And it grew 20 times bigger than that.
여러분 깜짝 놀랐죠.
Everyone, you are surprised.
저 물고기가
too, right?
안에 있었다고요?
Everyone, that fish was in the fish.
예, 저 코이의 물고기는 변하는 물고기입니다.
Yes, that koi fish is the fish that change.
여러분 저걸 가지고 사람들은 코이의 법칙이다라고 했어요.
Everyone, people, they call that Coy's law.
바로 무슨 말이냐면요.
What it means is
저 어항 안에는 저렇게 강물 같은 그렇게 클 수 있는 모든 조건이 들어 있어도
And the fish inside the fish bowl has all the potential and the power to become big.
어항 안에서는 더 이상 크지 않습니다.
As long as it is in the bowl, it will not grow.
사랑하는 우간다의 국민 여러분.
Our loving people of Uganda.
하나님을 사랑하시는 그리스도 여러분.
All of Christians who love God.
여러분 생각 이 어항 안에 갇혀 있지는 않습니까?
Isn't your thought inside the fish bowl?
이제 오늘 말씀으로 말미암아 여러분 어항에서 강물로 옮겨 오십시오.
And today, by the word, let your thoughts move out of the fish bowl and into the river.
여러분 우리가 하나님을 우리 마음에 모셨을 때,
Everyone, when we receive God in our hearts,
우리는 하나님의 형상을 따라 만들기 때문에,
and we are made in His own image.
하나님의 무한한 능력과 무한한 에너지를 우리 모든 인간에게 다 하나님은 선물로 주셨습니다.
And God, He has given us all. The unlimited power and potential inside of us as a gift.
짐승에게는 주지 않았습니다.
God did not give that to the animals.
사람에게는 하나님의 형상을 주셨습니다.
And God has given the image of God unto us.
하나님 안에 있는 무한한 능력과 지혜를 우리에게 다 주셨습니다.
Unlimited power and the wisdom that God has given us.
그러나 어항 안에서는 더 이상 자라지 않습니다.
And but then inside the fish bowl, it will not grow.
자 이제 여러분 생각이
Even your thoughts.
어항 안에 있습니까?
Is it inside the fish bowl?
연못에 있습니까?
Is it in the pond?
아니면 여러분 강가에 있습니까?
Or is it in the river?
여러분 이제 꿈을 꾸십시오.
Everyone now have a dream.
그리고 큰 꿈을 꾸십시오.
Everyone have a big dream.
그 꿈이 너무 커서 도달하지 못하는 걸 두려워하지 마십시오.
Everyone do not fear that that dream is so big that you may not be able to accomplish it.
꿈이 없는 게 문제입니다.
Actually, having no dream is the problem.
꿈이 너무 작아서 쉽게 도달하는 것 그것이 문제입니다.
If the dream is so small that you can easily achieve it, that's the problem.
꿈을 크게 가지십시오.
Have a big dream.
저 꿈을 가진 사람은 그 꿈에 한계를 두지 않습니다.
And those people who have a dream, they don't put the limitations to the dream.
그 꿈을 가진 사람은 함부로 살지 않습니다.
And people with a dream, they don't live however they want.
그 코이의 물고기에 큰 물고기에.
And so that big fish of the koi fish.
정말 그 꿈을 가진 사람은 저렇게 커질 수가 있습니다.
So those people with the dream, they can become big like that.
우리는 우간다 살아가는 여러분.
Our loving people of Uganda.
교회 여러분.
And our Christian all of you.
church 여러분.
And also the people of the church.
자, 여러분 이제 오늘 이 신년 1월 1일 이 아침에
And so this morning of the new year of the 1st of January.
이제 오늘 하나님 우리에게 주시는 말씀으로 우리는 강가로 옮겨 갑시다.
And so with the word that God is giving unto us, let us move over to the river.
우리의 꿈을 어항에다가 두지 맙시다.
Let us not put our dream in the fish bowl.
우리 꿈을 큰 강물로 옮기겠습니다.
And let us move our dream into the big river.
저는 위대한 그 사람들 중에서 토마스 엘바 에디슨을 제가 굉장히 존경합니다.
And so out of many great people in this world, I really respect Thomas Alva Edison.
왜냐하면 이 사람은요 인류 역사상 가장 많은 발명을 한 사람입니다.
Why? Because he's the one who has invented the most in the world.
여러분 우리는 이 에디슨 때문에 지금 전기불을 켜고 있습니다.
Everyone, because of Edison, we are using the electric lights.
그 전에는 우리는 촛불이나 또 등불을 우리 사용했죠.
And before we used to use the kerosene lights or the candle.
제가 초등학교 다닐 때만 하더라도.
And even when I was in the primary school.
예, 우리나라에도 역시 전기가 들어오지 않아서 촛불, 호롱불, 등불을 켰습니다.
Yes, also in our school, in my time, you know, we didn't have the electric light. That's why we used to use the candlestick.
근데 에디슨이가 전기불을 발견했어요.
And but then Edison invented the electrical
lights. 온 인류의 밤을 환하게 밝혔습니다.
And he had brightened the whole world with this light.
이 에디슨 때문에 우리는 영화를 볼 수 있었습니다.
And because of Edison, we are able to watch movie.
또 우리 에디슨 때문에 음악을 듣는 전축, 또 우리 목소리를 녹음하는 녹음기를 우리 사용할 수 있습니다.
And because of Edison, we are able to listen to the music through the speaker. We are also able to record our voices.
전기 냉장고.
And his invention, electrical refrigerator.
그리고 또 전화기.
And also telephone.
여러분 천 개 가지 이상 발명을 했습니다.
And so he invented more than 1,000 items.
이 사람은 천재 중에 천재.
And so he was the genius of the genius.
인류 역사상 임 사람만큼 발명을 많이 한 사람 있을까?
And so I am wondering, is there anyone who has invented more than this person?
여러분 이 에디슨만큼 정말 천재가 있을까?
And is there any other genius like Edison?
근데 재밌는 건요.
And but then the funny thing is.
이 에디슨이가 어릴 때 어머니 낸시하고 같이 지내는데
Edison when he was little he was living together with his mother Nancy.
근데 학교 선생님이 어느 날 낸시 엄마에게 편지를 보냈어요.
School teacher one day sent the letter to the mama Nancy.
초등학교 1학년 3개월 학교를 다녔는데
And so that time Edison was going to primary school class 1 just 3 months.
당신 아들 학교 보내지 마십시오. 당신 아들은 바보입니다.
And don't send your son to school anymore. Your son is a fool.
당신 아들은 머리가 유난히 큰데 그 돌린 것 같습니다.
And your son his head is big. It seems like your son's head is like a stone.
도저히 다른 애들하고 수업이 안 됩니다.
And he cannot catch up with other students.
정신적인 문제가 있습니다.
He has a learning disability.
학교 보내지 마십시오.
Don't send your son.
그 편지를 받았습니다.
And so she received that letter.
엄마는 그 편지를 받고 절망 속에 빠졌어요.
And the mother received that letter and she was in despair.
하나님, 우리 아들 에디슨이 바보입니까?
And God, my son Edison, he's a fool.
담임 선생님이 학교 오지 말라고 합니다.
The teacher said, don't send him to school.
하나님, 우리 아들 바보란 말입니까?
Oh God, my son, he's a fool.
어머니 낸시는 절망에 젖었습니다.
And the mother Nancy was in big despair.
그 편지를 침대 위에다가 올려놓고.
And she put that letter on the bed.
꿈에서 하나님께 기도를 했습니다.
And she knelt down and prayed before God.
하나님, 우리 아들 바보입니까?
Oh God, my son, he's a fool.
학교로 오지 말라고 합니다.
The teacher is telling him not to come to school anymore.
울면서 기도하고 있는데.
And she was praying.
하나님이 낸시에게 대답을 한 거예요.
And God answered to Nancy.
낸시야, 울지 마.
Hey, Nancy, don't cry.
그 에디슨 담임은 바보라고 했지?
Edison teacher said that he's a fool.
나는 에디슨을 천재로 만들 거야.
But I am going to make Edison a genius.
네가 바보가 되길 원하니 천재가 되길 원하니?
Do you want him to be a genius or do you want him to be a fool?
믿음대로 돼.
It shall be done according to your faith.
어머니 낸시는 그 이야기 들었습니다.
Mother Nancy heard about that.
하나님 천재로 보겠습니다.
Yes, God, I will see him as a genius.
그 천재라고 불러.
Yes, then call him genius.
예, 알겠습니다.
Yes, God, then I will do that.
에디슨 이리 와.
Hey, Edison, come here.
엄마 왜요?
Mom, why?
학교 선생님 편지가 왔어.
And I received a letter from your teacher.
내일부터 너 학교 오지 마래.
Starting from tomorrow, teacher said don't come to school.
에디슨 깜짝 놀랐어.
Edison was surprised.
뭐라고 엄마?
What, mom?
학교를 왜 하지 말라고요?
She's telling me not to come to school. Why?
선생님이 너는 천재래.
The teacher said, "You are a genius."
너는 바보고.
Other people are fools.
너는 워낙 똑똑한 천재라서 같이 수업이 안 된대.
You are such a great genius that you cannot study together with them.
그래서 너는 따로 천재 교육을 집에서 받으래.
And so she told me to you know, give you a special training
엄마,
for the
그래요?
genius.
내가 천재예요?
What, mom? I am a genius?
그래.
Yes.
엄마는 반대로 이야기했죠.
And the mother spoke the opposite.
에디슨은 그대로 그걸 믿은 거죠.
And but then Edison received that the way it is.
그리고 에디슨은 꿈을 꿨어요.
And Edison had a dream.
아, 천재구나.
아, I am a genius.
아, 내가 천재구나.
아, I am genius.
여러분 천재가 되었습니다.
Everyone, he became a genius.
천재 중에 천재.
He's the genius of the genius.
인류의 역사상 에디슨만큼 이런 천재가 없습니다.
And there was no genius like Edison in the mankind history.
만일 엄마가 거기서
If mother,
이 바보야,
Hey, you are a fool.
학교 선생님 오지 말해.
The teacher told you not to come to school.
울등하리래.
She said you are a fool.
다른 애들하고 지금 같이 정신적으로는 문제가 있대.
And so you have a learning disability. You cannot study together.
바보.
You fool.
말 그 땅 아무 일을 못 할
If that's what she said, then he probably cannot do anything.
천재 바보는 마음에서
Genius, fool, it is all made from the heart.
절망, 희망, 마음에서 만들어져.
Despair, hope, it is all made from our hearts.
여러분, 행복, 불행, 마음에서 만들어져.
Everyone, happiness, misery, it is all made from the heart.
아무리 어려워도,
no matter how difficult it is,
아무리 가난해도,
no matter how poor you are,
우리가 마음에서부터 이겨버리면,
Everyone, if you defeat it from your heart,
이길 수 있는 것입니다.
You can overcome it.
여러분, 우리 한국이 그랬어요.
Everyone, our country Korea was like that.
제가 1962년도에 내가 태어났는데요.
I was born in 1962.
제가 한국에서 초등학교 다닐 때.
And so when I was in primary school in South Korea.
우간다보다 더 가난한 나라였어요.
And South Korea was far behind than Uganda.
왜냐하면 우리는 남북 간에 전쟁이 있었습니다.
Why? Because we had a war between North Korea and South Korea.
3년 동안이에요.
And in 3 years of war. 3 million people died.
북한은 러시아하고 중국이 도왔고요.
And North Korea was helped by Russia and China.
남한은 미국과 유엔군들이 도와가지고요.
And South Korea was helped by UN and America. And we had war for 3 years.
300만 명이 죽었어요.
And 3 million people died.
모든 국토는 다 부셔졌어요.
And the whole land was destroyed.
모든 국민은 거지가 되었습니다.
And all people in Korea became beggars.
제가 1962년대에 태어났는데.
I was born in 1962.
우리는 아프리카의 가난한 어떤 나라보다 더 가난한 나라.
And so we were even more poor than any other countries in Africa.
세계 경제 전문가는 한국은 더 이상 일어설 수 없는 절망의 국가라고 했습니다.
World renowned economists said that South Korea will be a country that can never stand up again.
정말 그랬습니다.
Truly was like that.
피난여 피난민이 생기고
And because of war we had a lot of refugees.
전쟁에 고아들이 생기고
We had many orphans.
그리고 남편을 잃은 사람들도 많고
And we had so many people who became widowed.
다 잃어버렸
And we lost everything.
3년 전쟁의 모든 건물이 다
And 3 years of war, everything was destroyed.
정말 우리는 집이 없는 주어 과들이 많았어.
And truly, we had many orphans without home.
그리고 우리는 서울의 모습들로 보면.
And then when you look at the images of Seoul,
우리는 가난하게 살 수밖에 없어.
And truly, we could not help but live poor.
우리가 초등학교 제가 초등학교 때 우리의 모습입니다.
Actually, that is the picture when I was in the primary school.
서울 들어보셨어요?
Everyone, have you ever heard about Seoul?
혹시 드라마에서 서울 보셨습니까?
In drama, did you watch about Seoul?
70년대 우리 서울의 모습입니다.
Everyone, that is the image of Seoul in 1970s.
예, 정말 가난했습니다.
Truly, we were poor.
그리고 우리는 막 지저분한 막 도로에 그냥 쓰레기 더미가 있고.
And there was a lot of trash on the streets.
그리고 하수도에 물이 내려가는데요. 더러운 물이 내려가고.
And then there is a dirty water flowing in the sewage.
또 물은 썩어서 냄새가 나고.
And there was a lot of stench on the water.
비가 오면은 또 이제 막 거기에 똥물이 이거 들어가고.
And when there is a rain and then there is a lot of dung and urines.
아, 우리나라는 정말 가난한 나라예요.
And truly our country was a poor country.
자, 그런데 여러분 어떻게 이 우리나라가 세계가 부러워하는 이런 부자의 나라가 됐을까요?
Everyone, how can our country became a rich country that the whole world is envying?
예, 거기서 우리가 꿈을 가지게 되었습니다.
Why? Because we got to have a dream.
우리 한국은 불교의 나라, 우상의 나라, 저 나라입니다.
Everyone, Korea, South Korea is a Buddhist country and the country of believing in idols.
우리가 부모를 죽으면 귀신이 된다고 믿는 나라입니다.
And so we are the country believing that our ancestors become gods.
부모를 잘 섬겨야 되는 그런 나라였습니다.
And so we are the country that had to serve our parents very well.
그런데
이 나라에 하나님께서 불쌍히 여기셔서
And but then God had compassion upon our country.
50년 전에 성경이 들어왔습니다.
And 50 years ago we received the
그때부터
Bible.
그때부터 국민들이 성경을 읽기 시작했습니다.
And people they began to read the Bible.
물론 성경은 100년 전에 우리나라에 들어왔지만
Of course the Bible entered our country 100 years ago.
우리가 일본에 40년간 지배를 당하고
But we were colonized by Japan for 40 years.
또 남북전쟁이 또 있고
And we had a Korean War of North Korea and South Korea.
그래서 국민들에게 성경이 들어온 거는 불과 40년, 50년 정도밖에 되지 않습니다.
And so it's been only 40 50 years since people began to read the Bible.
우리가 우상을 버리고
And so we forsook the idols.
그리고 미신을 버리고
And we forsook other mischiefs.
그리고 우리는 성경을 받아들였습니다.
And we began to receive the Bible.
그리고 생각을 했습니다.
And we began to think.
그리고 우리가 도전을 했습니다.
And we challenged.
우리가 한계를 넘었습니다.
We went over the limitations.
우리 세계에서 제일 가난한 나라에 태어났습니다.
And so we are born in the poorest country in the world.
그러나 그건 우리의 죄는 아니다.
And but then that is not our sin.
그러나 우리가 죽을 때도 가난하게 죽는다면 그건 우리 책임이다.
And but then when we die, if we die poor, then that is our responsibility.
우리는 이 가난을 자녀들에게 물려주지 말자.
Let us not inherit this poverty to our children.
우리는 꿈을 가졌습니다.
And so we began to have that dream.
그리고 우리는 힘을 합치기 시작했습니다.
And we began to unite our strength together.
길거리에는 쓰레기가 넘치고
On the street there were a lot of trash.
그리고 도로가 포장이 안 돼 있고
And then the road was not paved.
하수구가 시설이 안 돼 있어서
And then there was no sewage system.
비가 오면 물이 넘치고
When it rains there was a lot of overflow.
네, 우리는 뭐 집도 형편도 없고
And the house was so terrible.
그런 나라였는데
And it was such a country.
정부가 그 일을 해 주지 않았습니다.
And but then the government did not do the work.
국민들이 생각을 했습니다.
People they began to think
정부가 가난해서
and the government is poor
우리에게 돈을 못 주더라도
they cannot pay us
그렇더라도 우리는 자원봉사를 하자
and but still let's work as the volunteers
정부가 돈을 안 줘도
even though government doesn't pay us
우리가 우리나라를 잘 사는 나라로 바꾸자
let's make our country into a country that lives well
그 운동이 새마을 운동이라 했습니다
and that movement is called the new village movement
그 새마을 운동이 정부에서
and through the new village movement
권장을 하고
and from the government is supported and they were taught in school
동네마다 사람들의 마음을 일으켜서
and in the villages they encouraged the people
아름다운 나라로 바꾸자
and let us change our country as a beautiful country
우리가 자원봉사하자
let us do the volunteer work
도로를 포장하자
let's pave the road
쓰레기를 치우자
let's move the trash
청소를 하자
let's clean
다리를 놓고
let's make the bridge
우리가 서로 힘을 합치자
let's unite our strength together
여러분 전 국민이 이 운동을 했습니다.
Everyone, the whole people participated in this.
그리고 우리 노래를
movement.
불렀습니다.
And then we sang the song.
우리도 한번 잘 살아보세.
Let us also live well.
그래서 온 국민들이 아침에 일찍 일어나서
and the whole people woke up in the
나라를
morning.
바꾸는 일을 했습니다.
And they did the work of changing the country.
정부는 시멘트를 주고
and the government will give them
우리는
cement.
포장을 하고
and we paved the road.
그리고 이제 정부에서 큰 기업 현대, LG, 삼성이나 이런 큰 기업을 일으키고
and then the government also support and raise the LG and Samsung and such forth.
그래서 정부도 도전을 하고
and also the government challenges
나라를 바꾸는 일을 했습니다.
And they did the work of changing the country.
자, 여러분 이 지금 하천이 청계서울 청계천 네, 네, 강물인데요.
Right now, this place is, you know, 청계천.
제가 70년도에 초등학교 다닐 때 우리 서울이 저 모습이었습니다.
And so, you know, in 1970s when I was in the primary school, Seoul was like that.
저기 어떻게 바뀌었는지 보여드리겠습니다.
Let me show you how that place changed.
예, 이렇게 바뀌었습니다.
It has changed like that.
여러분, 놀랍지 않습니까?
Isn't that amazing?
자, 여러분, 먼저 도로 도시가 바뀌기 전에.
Everyone, before the city changed.
먼저 우리가 생각을 바꾸었습니다.
And we first change our thoughts.
우리가 어항 속에 있는 코이 물고기처럼.
And like the fish inside the fish bowl.
우리 안 된다고 생각했습니다.
We thought that we can't change.
우리 절망의 나라라고 생각했습니다.
We thought that we are the country of despair.
우리가 경제의 원조를 받기 전에.
And so before we received the economic support.
생각을 바꾸었습니다.
We first change our thoughts.
그리고 우리 나라는 바뀌어졌습니다.
And then our country
자,
has
바뀌어진
changed.
모습을 사진으로 보여드릴게요.
Let me show you the picture of how Korea changed now.
자, 이제 70년대 우리 서울의 모습입니다.
And so this is the image of Seoul. Korea in 1970s.
예, 서울의 모습입니다.
And so this is the image of Seoul.
자, 예. 자, 우리나라는 산이 70%가 있는데요.
And so in our country, 70% of the land is the mountain.
아, 우간다는 너무 평지의 나라예요.
But Uganda is the country of a plain and flat ground.
특별히 저런 터널이 필요 없어요.
So you don't need those tunnels.
또 특별히 다리가 필요 없어요.
So you don't need bridges.
우리는 산이 70%이기 때문에.
And but Korea is 70% of mountains.
자, 우리는 도로를 터널을 만들어야 됩니다.
And so we had to make tunnels.
3,500개의 터널이 있습니다.
And there are 3,500 tunnels like that.
자, 그리고 저런 다리가 3만 개가 있습니다.
And then there are 30,000 bridges like that.
다음 그림 보시면
If you look at the next picture.
그 다리의 도로를 보면 저게 평지가 아닙니다, 여러분.
And so when you look at that road, that road is not flat ground.
다리인데
It's a bridge.
평지를 만들어 버린 겁니다.
And but they made a flat ground.
예, 우리 서울의 모습입니다.
This is the image of Seoul.
서울 신사당의 모습인데.
It's the image of 신사동.
제가 초등학교 때 저 모습입니다.
And it was like this when I was in primary school, but now it has changed.
이렇게 바뀌어졌습니다.
It's changed like this.
자, 여러분 보시기에 저 아파트가 작아 보이죠?
Everyone, that apartment looks small, right?
20층, 30층짜리 아파트입니다.
And, but those apartments are 20, 다음. 30 stories tall apartment.
예, 그리고 저 서울 남산이고요.
And that's Seoul 남산.
자, 이게 바뀌어졌습니다.
And now it's changed.
예, 이렇게 바뀌어졌습니다.
Now it's changed 다음. like this.
빨리 좀 넘겨주십시오. 야, 이게 서울 광화문 글인데요.
It's a 광화문 street.
자, 이게 바뀌어졌습니다.
Now it has changed.
14차선 도로까지 바뀌어졌습니다.
Now there's also now 14-lane road.
지금 여러분 보시는 그 도로가
And the road
14차선의
that you
도로까지 있습니다.
That is a 14-lane road.
좀 빨리 넘겨 주십시오. 송파구입니다.
네, 송파구.
자, 이렇게 바뀌어졌습니다.
Change like this.
자, 여러분 보이는 7만 명이 들어가는 스타디움이 있고요.
And that is the stadium that can fit 70,000
people. 아파트가 40층, 50층 아파트입니다.
And those apartments are 40, 50 stories.
여러분 보십시오.
Take a look at these.
그리고 아주 높은 빌딩 하나 있죠.
And there is that tall building over there.
123층 빌딩입니다.
And that is 123 stories tall apartment.
세계에서 네 번째 높은 큰 빌딩인데요.
And that is the fourth tallest building in the world. That is made with our technology.
저 너무 아름다운 야경까지 보여드리고
있죠. And it has a very beautiful evening view.
놀랍지 않습니까?
Isn't that amazing?
여러분, 우리는 이런 놀라운 세계를 만들었습니다.
Everyone, we were able to make this a wonderful world.
우리가 경제적인 원조를 받은 것이 아니라,
It's not that we received economic support.
마인드의 변화입니다.
It is a change of the mind.
온 국민이 어항에 있는 그 물고기가,
And now all people, you know, the koi fish that were inside the fish bowl,
강물 옮겨졌을 때,
they were moved to the river.
큰 스물 배까지 커지는 물고기가 커진 것처럼,
And now the fish became 20 times bigger.
전 세계에서 제일 가난한 우리나라가,
And now Korea, the poorest country in the world,
전 세계 역사상 이룰 수 없는 놀라운 일을 이루었습니다.
And this small country had accomplished things that the whole world could not accomplish.
그는 국민들의 꿈에 의해서 있습니다.
And it was done by the dream of the people.
2023년 1월 1일입니다.
And today is year 2023, first of January.
하나님을 사랑하는 우간다 국민 여러분.
And our people of Uganda who love God.
시청자 여러분.
And our viewers of UBC.
자, 오늘 이 아침 우리는 꿈을 가지십시다.
This morning, let us have a dream.
형편이 달라지기 전에.
And before the situation change.
꿈을 가지면.
Let's first have a dream.
그 꿈은 하나님 이루 주십니다.
Then God will accomplish that dream.
꿈을 크게 가십시오.
Have a big dream.
그래서 우리 제일 가난한 나라지만
And that's why we are the poorest country in the world.
세계에서 제일 잘 사는 나라로 우리 생각했습니다.
And but we thought of our country into the best country in the world.
이제 우리가 세계 무역을 보면요.
And so when you look
수출을
at
하고요.
And the trading
우리는 지금 이제 독일을 이겼습니다.
And now we have defeated Germany in trading.
프랑스를 이겼습니다.
And also France.
이탈리아를 이겼습니다.
And also Italy.
세계 수출 7위의 나라가 됐습니다.
And now we became the ranking number 7 in trading.
LG 현대로 삼성 LG로 인하여 여러분 우리가 세계 전자의 1위가 되었습니다.
And with Samsung and LG, South Korea became number one in electronics.
현대의 배를 만드는 게 세계 1위입니다.
Hyundai, they are number one in making ships.
자동차 만드는 세계 4위가 되었습니다.
Hyundai, you know, number four in making automobiles.
이런 모든 변화는 꿈을 가지는 데서부터 시작되었습니다.
All this change started from having the dream.
17살 요셉의 그 꿈이 많은 어려움 있었지만
The dream of Joseph of 17 years old he had a lot of difficulties.
늘 요셉은 꿈꿈을 생각하고 했습니다.
But he always thought about the dream that he had.
어린 있을 때마다 꿈꿈을 생각하고 했습니다.
He thought about the dream that he had it says.
꿈은 한계가 없습니다.
Dream does not have limitation.
꿈을 꾸는 사람은 함부로 살지 않습니다.
And those people who have a dream they do not live their life howeverly.
하나님 우리 우간다 국민들에게 꿈을 주셨습니다.
And today God has given to the people of Uganda the dream.
여러분 세계 최고의 나라입니다.
You are having the best country in the
좋지요.
world. The weather is good.
땅 크지요.
The land is big.
물 많지요.
You have a lot of water.
땅이 비옥하지요.
And the land is fertile.
많지요.
You have a lot of population.
생각만 바꾸면 됩니다.
You only need to change your thoughts.
그리고 하나님 믿음을 가지십시오.
And have the faith in believing in God.
그리고 우리가 서로 힘을 합치시다.
And let us unite our strength together.
제가 초등학교 때 모습이 지금 우간다의 모습이에요.
And so when I was in primary school, that image is like the image of Uganda.
자 이제 청소하십시오.
Now let's clean.
도로 포장을 하십시오.
Let's make the road.
국민들이 힘을 합치는 겁니다.
And you all bring your power together.
돈을 안 받아도
although you don't receive
우리나라를
money,
위하여
for my country,
내 이웃을 위해서
for my neighbor,
내 자녀를 위해서
for my children.
여러분 생각을 바꾸십시오.
Everyone change your thoughts.
충분히 할 수 있습니다.
You're more than able to do it.
우간다 아프리카 최고의 나라가 될 수 있습니다.
And now Uganda will be the best country in the world.
저는 어제 저녁 송구 영신 예배를 드렸습니다.
Yesterday I attended the Passover conference.
자 그래서 제가 어제 그 장보고 대학교의 세라다의 비숍의 초청을 받아서 제가 말씀을 전했습니다.
At the Changbogo University, I was invited by Dr. Serada, and then 그리고, I preached the word at the Passover.
예, 그리고 또 한 당군 다른 학문들 초청받아 갔는데요.
And then I was also invited by another Passover conference, and also
제가 이 말씀을 했습니다.
And I also spoke those words.
그리고 오늘 주 이 아침에도 이 말씀을
드리고
있습니다.
And also this morning, I am speaking to you this word.
여러분,
everyone,
사랑하는 여러분,
our loving people,
여러분 생각을 바꾸십시오.
Everyone, change the way you think.
놀라운 변화는 거기서부터 시작되죠.
And amazing change will happen from there.
저는 오늘 성경 민수기 21장 4절에서 9절까지 이야기를 드리려고 합니다.
And so I am trying to tell you about the book of Numbers, chapter 21, starting from verse 4 to 9.
거기에 무슨 이야기가 나오느냐면
And there is this story.
이스라엘 백성들이 21장 4절을 올리십시오. 이스라엘 백성들이 이제 애굽에서 나오게 됩니다.
Children of Israel, they come out of Egypt.
그리고 그 이스라엘 백성들은 읽어주십시오.
And they journeyed from Mount Hor by the way of the Red Sea to compass the land of Edom, and the soul of the people was much discouraged because of the way.
Next.
Verse 5. And the people spake against God and against Moses, where have ye brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no bread, neither is there any water, and our soul loatheth this light bread. Verse 6. And the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, and much people of Israel died. Verse 7. And therefore the people came to Moses and said, We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against thee. Pray unto the Lord that he take away the serpent from us. And Moses prayed for the people.
자, 여기서 잠깐만요.
Here,
자, 7절에서 가만.
In verse 7,
자, 여러분, 이스라엘 백성들이 불뱀에게 물렸습니다.
And people of Israel, they were bitten by the fiery serpent.
왜 불뱀이라 한 줄 아세요?
Do you know why it is called the fiery serpent?
마치 뱀에게 물리면 불에 탄 것처럼 고통을 느끼는 겁니다.
If you are bitten by the serpent, then you feel the pain as if you are burning.
그들은 소리쳤습니다.
And so they shouted.
그들은 괴로워했습니다.
And they were in pain.
그들은 추워하고 있습니다.
And they were dying.
불뱀 때문에.
And because of the fire serpent.
그래서 하나님 이 불뱀을 우리에게 좀 떠나게 해 주십시오.
And God, please let these fiery serpents go away from us.
모세요, 우리를 위하여 기도해 주십시오.
And Moses, please pray for us.
제발 이 불뱀을 떠나게 해 주십시오.
Let these fiery serpents go away.
8절에 보면요.
Verse 8.
읽어주세요.
And the Lord said unto Moses, Make thee a fiery serpent and set it upon a pole, and it shall come to pass that everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live.
하나님은 뱀을 떠나게 하지 않았습니다.
And so God did not make the fiery serpent to go away.
뱀을 그대로 백성들에게 물도록 했습니다.
And so they let the serpent to bite the people.
대신 하나님은 노수로 장대에다가 노뱀을 만들었습니다.
But then God told Moses to make the brass serpent upon a pole.
그리고 어떤 뱀에게 물렸든지,
and whichever serpent that you are bitten,
뭐 백마리에 물렸든지,
though you may be bitten by a hundred serpent, or 1,000 serpents.
상관없습니다.
It doesn't matter.
쳐다보면,
if you look upon it,
산다고 했습니다.
Then you shall live.
이 이야기가 바로 오늘 이야기인데요.
And so this is the story.
여러분, 이 이야기는
in this story,
여러분 성경에 나오는 모든 이야기는 예수님에 관한 이야기입니다.
Everyone, the whole story in the Bible is talking about Jesus.
여러분 병원의 앰뷸런스 차를 보면요.
Everyone, when you look at the ambulance in the hospital,
이 막대기에 뱀을 감아놓은 노뱀의 마크가 나와요.
And so there is the logo of the stick and the serpent around it. Eswatini.
그 다음에 짐바브웨에서 찍었습니다.
And the Zimbabwe ambulance.
그 다음에 잠비아에서 찍는다.
And Zambia.
빨리 놔주십시오. 그 레소토에서.
And also Lesotho.
예, 이게 우간다에서 찍습니다.
And this is a picture of Uganda.
그리고 르완다.
And Rwanda.
러시아.
And Russia.
모스크바.
Moscow.
브라질.
Brazil. America.
미국. 예, 중국.
China.
예. 자, 계속해서 이 앰뷸런스에 계속 넣어 주십시오.
And so, you know,
예,
this
비행기
ambulance,
안에도 지금 앰뷸런스는 저 비행기가 있어요. 빨리 빨리 넣어 주십시오. 자, 계속 넣어 주십시오. 계속 넣어 주십시오. 예, 저 마크가 나옵니다. 예. 예, 계속 넣어 주십시오. 예, 넣어 주십시오. UN 마크에서도
And also in the UN logo.
저 뱀 마크가 들어가면은 WHO가 됩니다.
And if you add that serpent logo, then it becomes the logo of WHO.
자, 그래서 여러분 이 저 마크가 병원에 사람을 살리는 마크인데요.
And so that logo is the logo of saving the lives of people.
왜 여러분 징그러운 뱀을 막대기에다가 저게 저 그림이 앰뷸런스에 있습니까?
Why do you think that logo of you know nasty you know snake is an ambulance?
저게 사람을 살리는 마크입니다.
That is the logo of saving the lives of people.
21장에 나오는
And it comes out in the book of Numbers chapter 21.
뱀의 독으로 죽어가고 있는데
And people are dying because of poison.
고통하고 있는데
People are in pain.
근데 노뱀을 쳐다봤는 사람은
But then those people who look upon the breast
독이 깨끗하게 나왔습니다.
And now they were healed from the poison.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
바로 저 노뱀은 예수님입니다.
And now that brass serpent is Jesus.
요한복음 3장 14절에
And John on chapter 3 verse 14.
우리 예수님 이야기합니다.
And our Jesus says
모세가 광야에서 뱀을 든 것 같이
As Moses lifted up the snake in the desert.
인자도 들려야 한다고 이야기했습니다.
So the son of man must be lifted up.
예수님 자로 노뱀이 바로 예수님 십자가를 이야기하고 있습니다.
And that brass serpent is the shadow image of the cross of Jesus.
그래서 15절에 예수님이 들린 사람은 다 낫는다고 했습니다.
And that's why verse 15 those people who look upon it shall leave.
자, 다음 번 보십시다. 다음. 예, 모세의 광야에 뱀을 들었죠.
And now Moses lifted up the brass serpent in the wilderness.
근데 사람들이 자기 생각을 믿은 사람은
And so people who are trusting in their own thoughts.
내가 뱀에게 물렸는데
I'm bitten by the serpent. Just because I'm getting would I be healed? That's nonsense.
죽습니다.
Then they die.
그러나 여러분, 노뱀을 쳐다본 사람은
And but those people who look upon it They leave.
예수님 뭐라고 합니까?
What did Jesus say?
모세가 광야에서 뱀을 든 같이.
As Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness.
다음, 인자도 들려야
Even the Son of Man must be lifted up.
바로 예수님으로 말미암아 되어지는 것을 볼 수가
있습니다.
We can see that it is done by 성경 구절도 주시죠.
So let us get the scripture.
자, 갈라디아서 3장 13절에 보면은
And Galatians chapter 13
율법의 저주를 우리 예수님이 그 담당을 하셨습니다.
And so Christ had to redeem us from the curse of the law.
자, 나무에 달린 자는 저주 아래 있는 자라 했습니다.
And so those who are on the tree are cursed.
자, 그래서 이 노뱀은
And that's why this serpent
바로 예수님의 십자가를 이야기를 할 수 있습니다.
And so this brass serpent is the shadow image of the cross.
다음 성경 구절 주십시오. 자, 여러분 여기 요한 베드로전서 2장 24절에 보면은
And so 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 24
예수님이 친히 나무에 달려서 우리 죄를 담당했다고 했습니다.
And so he says so who his own self bear our sins in his own body on the tree.
죄에 대하여 끝이 나버렸습니다.
And that we being dead to sin
우리 안에 들어오는 죄의 독
And the poison of sin that comes out of us.
사단의 독.
And the poison of Satan inside of us.
자, 예수님 십자로 끝나버렸습니다.
With the cross of Jesus, it all came to an end.
우리에게 의가 들어왔습니다.
And the righteousness 다음. came inside of us.
예. 여러분 이 죄가 있습니다.
Everyone, this person has a sin.
근데 이 죄를 양에게로 완수하게 되면
And, but when you lay your hands and pass over
그 죄가
your
제가
sin,
넘어가게 됩니다.
The sin is passed over to the lamb.
자, 넘겨주십시오. 예. 넘겨주십시오. 안 됩니까? 자, 그리고 이 세상에 있는 모든 죄가
All the sins of the world
예수님으로 말미암아 넘어가는 것입니다.
And by Jesus it is passed over unto Jesus.
고린도 후서 5장 방금 성경을 올려주십시오.
And so 2 Corinthians chapter 5
성경 뭐라고 이야기합니까?
So what did the Bible say?
고린도 후서 5장 21절에서
And so 2 Corinthians chapter 5
예수님은
verse 21
죄를 모르시는 분입니다.
And so Jesus is the one who does not know sin.
죄가 없는 분입니다.
He's the one with no sin.
그리고 우리의 죄를 예수님이 받으셨어.
And but then that Jesus received our sin.
그 죄가 예수님께 넘어갔습니다.
And that sin was passed over unto Jesus.
그래서 우리를 위하여 죽으시고 저주를 받으셨습니다.
That's why he received the curse on behalf of us and he died on behalf of us.
예수님 안에 있는 의를 우리에게 주셨습니다.
And now he has given us the righteousness of Jesus unto us.
다음 성경 주십시오. 그래서 히브리서 10장 10절에서는
And that's why in the book of Hebrews chapter 10 verse 10
예수님이 십자가에 못 박혀 죽으심으로 말미암아
And so you know by the death of the cross of Jesus
우리가 거룩함을 얻었습니다.
It says so we have been sanctified.
할렐루야.
할렐루야.
노뱀 대신 그 예수님이
And that Jesus of the brass
십자가에서
serpent
다 이루었다 하실 때
At the cross when he said it is finished.
모든 인간의 죄는
And all the sins of the people.
예수님으로 말미암아 영원히 끝이
나버렸습니다. By Jesus he came to an end eternally.
자, 이 성경을 다시 읽어 보겠습니다.
Let us read this scripture again.
이 뜻을 조차 예수 그리스도의 몸을 단번에 드리심으로 말미암아
And by that will We have been sanctified.
여러분 여기에 인간의 선한 행위를 넣지 마십시오.
And so do not put man's good works here.
우리가 죄를 많이 지었냐 적게 지었냐 거기에도 달리지 않았습니다.
And it is not about whether I committed a lot of sin or not.
예수 그리스도로 말미암아 됩니다.
It is by Christ Jesus.
예, 예수님 단번에 죽으심으로 말미암아 되었습니다.
And so it was done through the death of Jesus Christ once for all.
자, 더 놀라운 말씀합니다.
And there is also another amazing word.
14절입니다.
Verse 14.
자, 이제 제가 한 제물로 그런 영원히 온 적이 있습니다.
For by one offering he has perfected forever those who are being sanctified.
자, 불뱀에게 물린 그 독이 들어왔지만
And so you know, they received the poison of the serpent.
노뱀을 쳐다봤을 때
But when they look upon the brass serpent
뱀의 독은 없어져 버렸습니다.
And the poison is gone.
우리는 아담으로 말미암아 그 뱀의 독, 사단의 독이 우리에 들어왔습니다.
And by Adam, and that poison of Satan came inside of us.
죄의 독이 우리에게 들어왔습니다.
The poison of sin came inside of us.
십자가를 바라봤을 때,
but when we look upon the cross,
여러분 우리는 영원히 온전하게 되었습니다.
And we are perfected forever.
저는 이 말씀이 너무 좋습니다.
And for me this word is so good.
저는 날마다 내가 죄를 지은 게 기억이 납니다.
And so I still remember the sin that I committed.
그래서 가책이 되고 정죄가 됩니다.
And that's why there's a condemnation.
그 사단에게 속는 것입니다.
But that is being deceived by Satan.
10장 17절에서는 뭐라고 하냐면은
What did the chapter 10 verse 17
say? 저희 죄와 저희 불법을 내가 다시 기억지 않는다라고 이야기했습니다.
And the Bible says that for their sins and their iniquities will I remember no more.
할렐루야.
Hallelujah.
여러분 기억이 나는 거 안 나는 게 중요한 게 아닙니다.
Yes, so whether you can remember it or not is not important.
하나님이 기억에서 죄 버렸습니다.
And from your memory, he had already deleted it.
예수님 십자가로 말미암아.
Through the cross of Jesus.
다음, 그래서 로마서 8장 23절에서는
And that's why Romans chapter 3 verse
23. 자, 우리가 죄를 지어서 하나님 인간 이루지 못했습니다.
Everyone, we all have sinned and we come short of the glory of God.
우리 뱀에게 물렸습니다.
And we are beaten by the serpent.
뱀에게 우리 들어왔습니다.
And the poison of the serpent came inside of us.
24절.
But then 24 it says, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
자, 우리가 justified가 됐습니다.
The Bible says we are justified.
하나님의 은혜로.
And by the grace of God.
값없이.
And freely.
예수 그리스도로 말미암아.
And by Christ
redemption
Jesus.
이라고 이야기합니다.
The Bible says so through the redemption.
Eternal redemption입니다.
Eternal redemption.
예, 그래서 우리가 이제 결코 예수 안에 정죄함이 없다고
And
이야기하고
that's why the Bible says that there is now no condemnation.
절대 뱀의 독이 없습니다.
And now you don't have the poison.
정죄의 독이 절대 우리에게 들어올 수가
And
없습니다.
And now the poison of condemnation can never come inside of you.
할렐루야.
할렐루야.
자, 에베소 2장 8절에 보면
Ephesians chapter 2 verse 8.
저 우리가 하나님의 은혜를 믿음으로 말미암아 구원을 얻었나니.
It says by grace ye are saved.
이것이 너희에게 난 것이 아니요.
It says not of yourselves.
너희에게 난 것이 아니요.
Not of yourself.
너희에게 난 것이 아니요.
It is not from you.
하나님의 선물입니다.
It is the gift of God.
이는 공짜입니다.
This is free.
그래서 우리는 이 마지막 2장 9절에 보면
But when you look at chapter 2 verse 9.
그래서 not of works라고 했어요.
It says not of works.
우리의 행위가 아닙니다.
Not of our works.
바로 하나님의 은혜입니다.
It is by the grace of God.
하나님의 선물입니다.
It is the gift of God.
그래서 우리는 자랑할 수 없습니다.
That's why we cannot boast.
난 착하게 살아서 난 선하게 살아서
I live the good life.
자랑할 수 없는 겁니다.
We cannot boast.
여러분 사랑하는 우리 우간다의 여러분 크리스찬 여러분.
Our Christian everyone.
오늘 1월 1일입니다.
Today is the 1st of January.
꿈을 가지십시오.
Let's have a dream.
그 꿈은 바로 현실이 될 수 있습니다.
And that dream will be the reality.
우리 한국 사람들이 꿈을 가졌어.
Koreans we had a dream.
세계가 깜짝 놀라는 나라를 바꿨듯이.
And we changed into a country that the whole world is surprised.
이제 우간다의 그리스도인 여러분으로 말미암아.
And now by our Christians of Uganda.
이 일들은 이루어질 수 있는 것이.
And now these dreams can be accomplished.
하나님의 축복이 우간다의 여러분에게. 나라와 국민들에게 임하기를 바랍니다.
And I pray that the blessings of God shall come upon the country and
감사합니다.
the people of Uganda. Thank you very much.
예? 더 하라고요? 아, 그렇습니까? 아, 예, 예. 아, 예. 너무너무 감사합니다.
I'm so thankful.
그래서 오늘 이 말씀을 통해서
And so through this word,
하나님 오늘 우리에게 놀랍게 말씀하고 계십니다.
And God is speaking to us amazingly.
여러분 오늘 저는 여러분들에게 성경을 한 구절 한 구절 읽어드렸습니다.
And so today I have shown you the Bible scripture one by one.
자 이스라엘 백성들은 하나님을 원망했습니다.
And so children of Israel they complained to God.
자 그들은 불뱀에게 물렸습니다.
And they were bitten by the serpent.
그리고 불뱀에게 물리지 않는 사람도 있었습니다.
And there were also people who were not bitten.
물리지 않으려고 도망을 갑니다.
And they were running away so that they may not be bitten.
그 불뱀이 따라옵니다.
And now that fiery serpent is following
그래서
you.
그래서 이스라엘 백성들이 이야기합니다.
And now children of Israel say,
오 하나님,
Oh God,
우리가 잘못했습니다.
Oh, we are wrong.
우리가 하나님께 감사하지 못했습니다.
And we cannot thank you, Lord.
하나님 우리를 이스라엘 백성들이 이끌어 주셨는데.
And God, you have saved us from Egypt.
하나님, 우리가 잘못했습니다.
And but then we are wrong.
이 불뱀을 우리에게 떠나게 해 주십시오.
And so let these fiery serpents go away.
백성들은 불뱀이 떠나가게 해 달라 했어요.
And so the people asked the fiery serpent to go away.
그런데 여러분.
But then everyone.
하나님은 불뱀을 그대로 뒀습니다.
God kept the fiery serpent the way it is.
바로 이게 인간의 생각하고 다른 생각입니다.
Everyone, this is the difference between God's thought and man's thought.
우리는 불뱀이 떠나가기를 원했죠.
And so we wanted the fiery serpents to go away.
우리가 슬픔이 떠나가고.
We wanted the sadness to go away.
어려움이 떠나가고.
We wanted the difficulties to go away.
문제가 떠나가고.
We wanted the problems to go away.
또 죄가 떠나가고.
We want the sin to go away.
우리가 죄에게 안 물렸으면 좋겠죠.
And so we wish that we are not bitten by sin.
우리가 죄 안 지었으면 좋겠죠.
We wish that we do not commit sin.
우리는 그렇게 싸웠습니다.
And so we fought like that.
뱀과 불뱀과 싸우는 이스라엘 백성처럼.
And so like the children of Israel who are fighting with the fiery serpents.
우리가 죄를 이기려고 했습니다.
And so we try to overcome sin.
그런데
But then,
우리가 죄를 이기는 게 아닙니다.
And so it is not us who is overcoming sin.
네, 하나님이 불뱀을 떠나 보내면 되죠.
And so yes, God can just send away the fiery serpents.
예, 그러면 되죠.
And then he can do it.
그렇게 하지 않았습니다.
But he didn't do it like that.
여러분, 불뱀에게 떠나 보내면
Everyone, if we send away the fiery serpents.
불뱀에게 안 물린 사람들은 괜찮죠.
And then those people who are not bitten, then they're okay.
그럼 불뱀이 물린 사람은 어떻게 됩니까?
And but what happened to those people who are bitten already?
불뱀이 떠난다고 해결이 되나요?
And just because he sent it away, is the problem going to solve?
안 되잖아요.
It's not going to be solved.
이미 뱀에 들어왔는데.
Already poison came inside.
그래서 하나님은요.
So that's why God.
뱀을 뒀어요.
He kept the fiery serpents.
그리고 장대에 달린 노뱀을 쳐다보고.
And then he has given them the breast serpent upon a pole.
예수님이 십자가죠.
That's the cross of Jesus.
그 노뱀만 쳐다보면 되는 것입니다.
And if you only look at the brass serpent, then you'll be healed.
여러분, 우리 조상 아담이 있습니다.
Everyone, we have our ancestor called Adam.
그리고 우리의 그 아내 하와가 있습니다.
And we also have Eve.
자, 그래서 아담과 하와에게 하나님 에덴 동산을 주셨습니다.
And God had given the garden of Eden to Adam and Eve.
하나님 모든 과일 다 주셨습니다.
And so God has given all the fruits.
그러나 동산 중앙에 있는 선악을 알게 한 나무를 먹지 마라
했습니다. But God said, "Do not eat the fruit in the midst of the garden."
말씀하셨습니다.
And God said,
이것을 먹는 날에는
On the day that you eat of it,
정령 죽으리라.
You shall surely die.
자, 그래서 아담과 하와는 그 나무를 쳐다보지 말았어요.
And so Adam and Eve, they were not supposed to look at that tree.
하나님 말씀 있을 때는.
And so when there was the word of God,
관심도 없습니다.
They were not even interested.
절대 먹지 않습니다.
And so they never ate it.
그런데,
but then,
아주 간계한 에덴 동산에 뱀이 있었어요.
And there was the serpent, which was very cunning.
그 성경의 요한계시록에서 그 옛뱀이라고 하는데요.
And so in the book of Revelation, it is called the old serpent.
마귀라고도 하는 그 사단이었습니다.
And it was the Satan, which is called also the devil.
바로 그 마귀가 아담을 유혹합니다.
And now that devil tempted Eve.
선악을 따먹으라고.
And to eat the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil. No, I can't.
이거 먹으면 죽는다고.
If I eat it, then I will die.
아니, 안 죽어.
No, you are not going to die.
결코 죽지 않아.
You will never die.
네가 하나님께 속은 거야.
And you are deceived by God.
이거 먹으라고 죽는 거 아니야.
Although you eat it, you are not going to die.
너 이거 먹으면.
If you eat it.
너 눈이 밝아진다.
You'll be like God, you know, opening your
그리고
eyes.
그리고 너 지혜가 들어와.
And you have the wisdom.
너 그럼 얼마나 행복하게 사는 줄 몰라.
And imagine you are going to live a very happy life.
뱀이 속였습니다.
And so the serpent had deceived her.
뱀이 아담을 물었습니다.
And the serpent bit Adam.
아담 그 소리를 들었죠.
And Adam also heard that.
선악과를 따서
And ate the fruit of knowledge of good and evil and ate it.
아내에게도 줬습니다.
And also gave to the wife.
둘 다 먹었습니다.
And also she ate.
그들 눈이 밝아졌습니다.
And their eyes were opened.
그들이 벌거벗은 걸 봤습니다.
And they saw themselves being naked.
부끄러웠습니다.
They were ashamed.
하나님 아담아.
And God said, Adam.
네가 어디 있느냐?
Where are you?
나무 뒤에 숨었습니다.
And so he hid behind the tree.
그때는 예 하나님.
And that time, yes, God.
아, 너무 자유롭죠.
Yes, he's so free.
Oh, hello, how are you?
Yes, hello, how are you, God?
좋았죠.
Yes, he was so happy.
나무 뒤에 숨었습니다.
But now he's hiding behind
아담아,
the tree.
아담아, 네가 어디에 있느냐?
Adam, where are you?
하나님, 내가 벗었으므로 두려워하여 숨었나이다.
And God, I am naked and I'm fearful and I hid.
무슨 소리입니까?
What does that mean?
옷을 입었는데 벗었다 말입니까?
And so, you know, he was wearing the clothes
옷이 없었습니다.
From the beginning, he was naked.
아무 문제가 없었습니다.
He didn't have any problem being naked.
그런데 문제는 뭡니까?
But what is the problem?
자기를 쳐다봤다는 거죠.
Now he saw himself.
여러분, 자기의 치부 부끄러운 부분을 봤다는 것이죠.
And so he saw his leggings.
그럼 그 전에는 안 벗었습니까?
And then before he was naked.
벗은 것이 문제가 아니라.
Being naked is not a problem.
벗은 것을 문제 삼는 그 마음.
And now, you know, that the heart which is causing the problem of being naked.
하나님과 다른 마음이라는 것입니다.
And so that is the different heart from God.
하나님과 다른 마음, 그 마음이 문제라는
And
것입니다.
And so that different heart from God is the problem.
바로 그게 죄입니다.
And that is sin.
바로 그게 사탄의 독입니다.
And that is the poison of Satan.
결국은 사탄의 독이 아담과 하와에 들어왔고요.
And now that poison of, you know, a serpent came inside of Adam and Eve.
그리고 그 독은 이제 모든 인간에게 다 넘어왔습니다.
And that poison is spread to all human beings.
아까 성경 본 것처럼 로마서 3장 23절에 모든 사람이 죄를 범했음에 하나님의 영광이 이르지 못했다.
Like the verse that we saw in the book of Romans chapter 3 verse 23 it says for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
모든 인간의 뱀의 독이 다 들어왔습니다.
Why because the serpent the poison of the serpent came into
모든
all.
모든 인간들은 뱀에게 다 물렸습니다.
And so all human beings we are bitten by the serpent.
자, 뱀의 독이 들어왔습니다.
And now the poison of the serpent came inside.
근데 뱀이 떠나가면 됩니까?
And then can the serpent just go away?
아닙니다, 여러분.
No, everyone.
모든 사람들은 지금 다 뱀에게 물렸습니다.
And so everyone they're all bitten by the serpent.
죄 안 짓는다고 되나요?
And so if you try hard, then you will not
sin.
You will just
try to live a good
life. You can just try to live a good life. You just have to help other people. You just have to pray a lot. You need to keep the law well.
안 됩니다.
No, it's not going to work.
뱀의 독이 들어왔습니다.
The poison has already come inside of you.
뱀이 떠나가야 되는 게 아닙니다.
It's not that the serpent has to go.
죄 안 지어야 되는 게 아닙니다.
It's not that you should not sin.
착하게 살아야 되는 게 아닙니다.
It's not that you should live a good life.
그건 인간의 생각입니다.
That is the man's thought.
그러니까 하나님 모세가 하는 게 기대했을 때
And so when God when Moses prayed to God
하나님 불뱀을 떠나지 않았습니다.
And God did not send away the fiery serpents.
불뱀을 그대로 뒀습니다.
And now kept the fiery serpents the way it is.
그리고 장대 달린 노뱀을 쳐다보겠습니다.
And then made people to look upon the brass serpent upon a pole.
뱀의 독이 있지만
And there's the poison.
뱀의 독으로 죽어가고 있지만
And you are dying because of the poison.
너무너무 고통스럽지만
You're so painful.
그러나 이제 뱀의 독을 가지고 노뱀을 쳐다보게 되었었을 때
And but you know because of the poison when you look upon the brass serpent They were able to leave.
뱀의 독이 없어졌습니다.
The poisons are gone.
여러분 모든 인간에게 있던 그 사탄의 독, 뱀의 독이.
Everyone, all the poisons which were inside of you.
예수님 십자가를 쳐다봤을 때.
And so when you look upon the cross of Jesus Christ.
우리의 모든 죄가 다 씻었어요.
And so all of our sins are washed.
사탄의 독이 없어졌습니다.
And now the poison of Satan is
죄의
gone.
죄의 독이 없어졌습니다.
The poison of sin is gone.
사망의 독이 없어졌습니다.
And the poison of death is gone.
정죄의 독이 없어졌습니다.
And the poison of condemnation is gone.
할렐루야.
Hallelujah!
Praise the Lord!
Praise the Lord!
바로 여러분 이것이 복음입니다.
Everyone, this is the gospel.
바로 이것이 기쁜 소식입니다.
Everyone, this is the good news.
2023년 1월 1일 사랑하는 우간다 국민 여러분.
Year 2023, the 1st of January, our loving people of Uganda.
또 UBC 시청자 여러분.
And our viewers of UBC.
그리스도를 사랑하는 크리스찬 여러분.
And our Christians who love Christ.
오늘 이 말씀을 믿으십시오.
Today, believe in this word.
이제 이 말씀은 하나님 우리에게 놀라운 역사를 이루셨습니다.
Now this word is going to bring a great works of God.
뱀의 독이 없어졌습니다.
And now the poison of the serpent is gone.
예수님 십자가로 말미암아.
By the cross of Jesus Christ.
저주의 독이 없어졌습니다.
The curse, the poison of curse is gone.
죄의 정죄가 없어졌습니다.
There is no condemnation of sin.
이것을 믿는 여러분 되십시오.
And I hope all of you can believe in this.
2023년 1월 1일 새해 아침.
And this is the new morning, new dawn of year 2023, the 1st of January.
여러분, 저주의 독이 다 없어진 것을 믿으십시오.
Everyone believe that all the poisons of serpent is gone.
슬픔의 독이 없어진 걸 믿으십시오.
And believe that poison of sadness is gone.
불행의 독이 끝난 걸 믿으십시오.
Believe that poison of despair has come to an end.
꿈을 꾸십시오.
And have a dream.
거룩하게 됐습니다.
And now you are made sanctified.
영원히 온전하게 되었습니다.
Now you are justified forever.
그것을 믿는 여러분 되시기를
바랍니다. I hope all of you can believe in this.
오늘 2023년 새해 아침 여러분 만날 수 있어서 너무 감사하고요.
New dawn of year 2023. I'm so thankful to meet with all of you.
하나님께 영광을 돌립니다.
And I glorify God.
예, 우간다 이 나라를 축복해 주시고.
And now God will bless Uganda.
국민들을 축복해 주시기를.
And we pray that He will also bless the people. And also today,
아침에 메시지 전할 수 있어 너무 감사합니다.
In this new dawn, thank you so much for inviting us to deliver the New Year message.
주님께 영광 돌립니다.
And I glorify God.
예수님 감사합니다.
And Jesus, thank you.
뱀의 독을 없애신 주님 감사합니다.
And that Jesus who removed that poison of the serpent, we thank you.
예, 감사합니다.
Thank you very much.
해피 뉴 이어 유간다
Amazing grace How sweet the sound That saved the wretch like me I
Paying for groceries the old way.
3, 4, yeah.
Allow me.
Paying for groceries with the My Airtel app. You have the power in your pocket. The power to conveniently pay for goods and services. Unlock that power with the My Airtel app. Visit the App Store or Google Play now.
That's my wife.
Following the cabinet approval to conduct the National Population and Housing Census in August 2023, the Uganda Bureau of Statistics would like to inform all stakeholders and the general public that pre-census activities already started with census mapping across the whole country. Census mapping provides an up-to-date list of enumeration areas and administrative units in the country. In addition, it determines the number of enumerators and supervisors required for undertaking the census. Census, it matters to be counted. For more information, contact the Office of the Executive Director, Uganda Bureau of Statistics on 0755-342-128. This message is brought to you by the Office of the Executive Director, Uganda Bureau of Statistics.
The festive season is here and it's Christmas in 4G from Airtel.
Airtel. Get the most affordable 4G smartphone in Uganda, now heavily discounted from 250,000 shillings to 150,000 shillings only. Yes! 150,000 shillings only to keep you connected to your loved ones this holiday season.
Dial *175*94# to activate free 1GB instantly and 100% double data on all weekly and monthly bundles for 3 months. Get one today while stock lasts from the nearest Airtel shop. Happy holidays this festive season with Airtel, the smartphone network.
Capital Shoppers, we have a variety of items like gift hampers, foods, garments, cosmetics, and all sorts of drinks. Enjoy your shopping experience this festive season at affordable prices in our fully stocked branches in the following areas: in Ntinda Station Road, opposite Makere Business School along Port Bell Road, Duster Street opposite Nakasero Market, and Garden City on Yusuf Lule Road. At Capital Shoppers, we offer you value for your money. To all our customers and suppliers, we thank you for your continuous support. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
My name is Pastor Doreen Kamese from the Way to Heaven Church in Ntinda. I love God so much. I'm so happy to be talking to you. I'm so happy to love God and to serve God. Thank you for those who attended our 31st night. It was powerful, it was marvelous. We love you so much, and we believe that you did not remain the same, because me myself, my life is a new life now, and I believe you also a new creature of God. I have been serving God for around I'm making 13 years officially, but then I have served God more than 20 years. I have loved God, and I have seen God answering all prayers. I don't know what you prayed for, but I want to assure you that all your prayers are answered. Our God is a faithful God. As long as you do what He wants you to do, be sure, be expectant that all your prayers are answered. There is this word that we shared, or we always share. This verse is found in Matthew chapter 5, verse 13, where the Bible says that we are the salt of the earth. But when the salt loses its saltiness, something goes wrong, and automatically the food will not remain the sweet food. So in this 2023, my dear friends, daughters, sons, fathers, mothers, young and old ones, please make sure you keep the salt. You keep the salt. The Bible is not telling us to lose the salt, but to keep the salt. When the food loses its flavor, it's no longer food. You want to eat meat and you're like, I'm eating meat. You want to eat yellows and you're like, I'm eating yellows. But if you were eating yellows and the yellows are sour, then they are no longer yellows. So in this 2023, I want to beg you, I want to pray for you, that we shall keep the salt that we were created with. God knew us before He created us in our mother's wombs, and He knew that we shall remain in His image. So don't go away, don't get out of His image. He's ready to bless us as he blessed our grandpa Abraham. He blessed him until the man became a blessing into the nation. So, children of God, we can pray, we can believe God, we can remain as salt as he created us, so that we can receive his blessings until we become blessings to the whole nation. God loves us so much. 2023 is a year of divine grace, is a year of higher expectations, is a year that God is going to fulfill everything that he promised us, is a year of true prophecies. And I believe that the good Lord is with us. He wants to see us coming out of problems. He promised us that in 2023, we shall not lack. If you can keep that in your mind, we shall not lack. In 2023, we must see his goodness. In 2023, we must see his promises coming to pass into our lives. What do I mean by saying that? We must believe in him. We must seek him diligently. Let us seek God diligently. Let us seek God diligently. If you can keep that in your heart, then you will see God. God is so, so faithful. But then in 2023, he's going to be more faithful. My expectations are higher. He has been so faithful to us. He has been so good to us. I believe he's going to do more and more and more. As you know that he always blesses us in abundance. So children of God, stay alert. Stay waiting. Give him time. Meditate about his goodness. Meditate about this divine grace, where he's going to do things that we have never seen, where he's going to do to answer our prayers the way we have never seen. Let us seek him diligently. Let us meditate about his goodness, because he has been good. If you're not dead today, you're supposed to say thank you to God. If you're not sick today, why not to lift your hands high and say thank you, Lord? If you're not in a prison, why not to believe God more and tell other people that my God is a faithful God and he's doing more than I expected? Children of God, make sure you seek God. Make sure you read the word. Make sure you believe in the word. And make sure you continue talking about his name. I'm saying this as my last point. Make sure, give God the first. Give God the first, the first place, the first fruit, the first. Give God the first. Put him your number one. And believe that since he's first in your life, you will be first in his plans. May God bless you. We love you so much. I continue to prophesy for the goodness of God. I continue to prophesy that no one is going to die or to live in poverty. Our God is faithful. We are blessed and we are healed. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We are located in Itinda. If you live in Kampala, please have time, come and fellowship with us. Your life will never remain the same. We love you so much. I'm called Dorini Kamese. I'm the senior pastor of the Way to Heaven Church in Itinda. May God bless you and have a blessed year.
Michael Chimuli is my name, the team leader, senior pastor of Christian Discipleship Ministries International here at Kololo. I would like to wish you a prosperous and successful new year 2023. I know that God is about to make someone laugh. I know. If he made Sarah laugh, a woman who was barren, a woman who had no hope. I know that he can make you laugh. You know, God gave me a scripture in the book of Isaiah chapter 43 verses 18 and 19. Do not remember the former things, nor consider things of the old. Behold, I do a new thing, now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I'll even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. God is speaking to us and telling us to forget about the old. I know 2019 was another different year, 2020, talk about 2021, but when it comes to 2023, I believe that in the middle of what you call a desert, the wilderness, a place of hopelessness, a place of heat, a place of loneliness, you know, that's the wilderness, that is the desert. You know, a desert is different. It has heat. It seems to be like you are lonely, you are all alone. But God is creating a river in the midst of the desert. He's about to do something new in your life. You better change your mind now and focus on God's heart. Focus on God's love for you. The Bible says, I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you, to give you a good and desired end, future, not to harm you, not to give you lack or all pain. But God is really promising something. It may not be to everyone, but those who are going to open their hearts and receive this word, I believe God is doing something new. I mean spiritually, physically, materially, and it all begins in the spiritual. If God is going to renew you in the spirit, He is going to do even other things. So this is what I want to tell you, that don't consider the things of the old. Don't talk about the old. God is doing something new. Don't forget about the old awakenings and old encounters. There is another encounter that is coming. There is another wave of the Holy Spirit that is coming upon the church. There is another visitation that is about to come. There is certain things that God is going to pluck out so that He can plant, you know. And when He begins to pluck out, don't be afraid. When He's closing certain doors, don't be afraid, because He wants to open gates. As He's closing doors and windows, He's opening gates. May this year be a grateful year, which we have entered with thanksgiving, because the Bible says that enter into His gates with thanksgiving and into His courts with praise. Just keep praising God prophetically, knowing that praise and thanksgiving opens gates. Thank God for the past, for 2022. We survived a lot. But this year, the Lord is saying, behold, I'm doing a new thing. A new thing. Where? In your family. Where? In your job. Where? At your place of work. In your business. God is saying, I'm doing a new thing. And you see it. And not only you, everyone around you will see it. May the Lord put you up as a billboard to advertise His goodness, His power, His love. May you become an advertising board where God's love will be written on you, God's power, and people will point at you and say, look at what God has done. Either in transformation, in change of certain habits, in change of your status, change in position, something new is coming your way. May the good Lord bless you. I wish you a wonderful, successful, prosperous 2023, full of God's favor. I know that some of you would like to receive Jesus, and that is a new step. That is the first thing that God wants to do. Behold, I'll do a new thing. And the first new thing He wants to do in your life is salvation. He's giving you the way. He's inviting you to Himself. So if you're there and you've never given your life to Jesus, just say after me, Jesus, come into my heart today. Take my name or delete it from the book of death and write it in the book of life. From today, I receive you as my personal savior, and I want to confess that you are the Son of the Living God. You'll be my savior always. You'll be with me always. You'll protect me. You'll guide me by your spirit. And today, I have given you my heart. Amen. If you don't have a place of fellowship, please, and you are around here, you're around town, you know, from Nakawa, from different places, Chambogo, talk about this town, Kololo. Our church is in Kololo. Kololo, Sahet Kesbe Road, near Lugogo Indoor Stadium. That car road is called Sahes Kesbe Road. You can even put in a Google map and say you put CDMI Church, Kololo, and you'll be right there. They will bring you the place on the Google map. So we're waiting for you. We're ready to receive you with love. And CDMI, Christian Discipleship Ministries International, is a family. And you'll feel a family welcome. You'll feel a family, that warmth in the family. May the good Lord bless you as you find your way here. Hallelujah.
Fellow Ugandans, praise the name of the Lord. And can I say Happy New Year? We are no longer wishing for Happy New Year. We are already in the new year. Woo! Hallelujah. Who knew of those moments? I remember those days of 2019, 2020, 2021, especially 2021. My goodness, we were kept in the house. We couldn't move anywhere. Things were really, really bad. But praise the Lord. It is by the grace of God that you and I are preserved. It is by His mercy that you are not consumed. Praise the Lord. I know you have not gotten everything that you needed. You had to go through some terrible, challenging years. But the good thing that your health is here. You are still here. Some other, those who are watching me, others may not be healthy, well enough in your bodies. Maybe you are not okay financially, but praise the Lord that you are still alive. And I want to thank God for UBC, Star TV, administration for having called upon and moved around pastors to share their hearts about New Year. I have three words, and the two words are from the Lord, and one word is from me. One word that I can share with you now is about loving our nation. I am urging all Ugandans in these next 12 months to walk each day, each passing day, loving our nation. The nations like America, the United States of America, had many nations until they came to a resolution that we need to be Americans, not Westerners or Easterners. The moment we desire that, and the moment we grasp that, Uganda is going to be one of the best countries in the world. Recently, I was also visiting a neighboring country in Rwanda. Also, I realized that the issue of Hutu and Tutsi is also abolished now. You are Rwandese. And there's no high class or lower class. The development that is going there, I also was so much amazed to see what's happening there. In the United Kingdom, there are four nations. There's the Welsh, Scottish, the English, and Ireland, Northern Ireland. But although at one time they fought each other until they realized that we can't keep fighting. This is our country. And they developed into what they call UK, United Kingdom. Of course, they have their differences in other things. But when it comes to development, national building, welfare, they all speak one language. They have the same medical services. They are embracing everybody in that nation, in those nations, they embrace it. For Ugandans, the Lord has blessed us with oil. God has blessed us with mineral resources. But if those mineral resources come to people who are divided, then we are going to have a Uganda which is full of potholes, a Uganda that's full of challenges and bickerings and levels of classes and tribes. I am praying for patriotism. If you are patriotic, Uganda is going to be a better country. This is not has nothing to do with spiritual. This is to do about our country. If you are having a trash and you just cast it, throw it in the road, The union, you are not a Ugandan. All of us must be a brother's keeper. Uganda is a very rich country, rich in culture, and such time we embrace our culture, destroy our differences, religious differences. When it comes to development, religiously, forsake it. When it comes to development, culturally, there's no Muganda, there's no Munyankole, there's no Muchiga. I am urging the next, this year that we're having, that the word the West, the East, the Central, the North should abolish. We saw this in the elections, the last elections. But now, it's my prayer, and it has been my prayer. You and I who are still alive, we bring up a Uganda which has no tribes. It has tribes per se, but which has one language. That is the word from the bottom of my heart as I desire to see things happening. Number two, another word that God gave me is from Joshua chapter 5. In Joshua chapter 5, the people that came from Egypt fought, and many of them died in the wilderness. But we had, after they had crossed Jordan, River Jordan, there were other nations to take over. But remember, the old people had died now because of plagues and all that. Now there were these little kids who needed to take over the land. The land was ready, everything was ready. But the one problem they had, they had not been circumcised. In the Old Testament, everybody who followed Abraham had to be circumcised. And circumcision was a sign of righteousness, peeling off the... peeling off the past. So they had come out of Egypt, but many of the old people died. Now that they are dead, they can't inherit the land. If they cannot inherit the land, there's a young generation ready to take the land. But the problem is, they are not circumcised. They don't have a chance to circumcise them. And the prerequisite, and one of the conditions for them to inherit the land is that they are circumcised. For God would only see that. It's a physical thing in the Old Testament, but it was a requirement for righteousness as far as receiving the blessings of Abraham are concerned. Now, if we bring it in our language, for those of you who are listening now, what is Bunyo saying? We as individuals, we must be sanctified. This year, 2023, should be a year of forgetting the past. God is doing something new. He's doing things afresh, but the past must go. If you have an outer coat or part skin that is unforgiveness, resentment, anger, tribalism, all sorts of things, God is calling everybody to come to the cross and sacrifice your sin. Sin brings reproach to a nation, but righteousness exalts a nation. If you are to succeed in the next financial year, in the next executive year, political year, church year, that's where we are. Pastors, from the president, from state house to the least house of those young men that stays on the street, in the corporates, I am praying that righteousness will prevail. They were ready to take Canaan land and everything, but God could only favor them if their skins had been peeled off, especially their foreskins. In the nutshell, God is calling for freshness of our spirits, that our hearts will be circumcised, be forgiven, and accept forgiveness. Don't play with sin, but walk with righteousness and in the light of God. That is the word of God. Another word that God has given for this year, it's a year of divine, amazing grace. Again, it comes through Second Samuel. You shall read there. 2 Samuel chapter 2, chapter 9. King Saul is dead on the same day with his son. But one of the sons of Jonathan, the nurse that was taking care of this son, I think he was young, as young as 5 years, maybe 10 years. As they had the news about the death of his father and the death of his grandfather, King Saul, the nurse that was taking care of this kid also ran, because they knew that the change of government means now that they are going to kill everybody who was persecuting David, especially the house of Saul. So what happened? As they were running, this young man, the little boy fell on his knees and he broke his legs. So he was incapacitated. Others were exiled to other Syrian nations. They could not live in the country. Now, what happened? When King David came in power, to power, the first thing he announced, I want to do kindness, to show kindness to anybody that is remaining in the house of Saul. And they say, oh, there is this young man, the lame boy. He says, oh, is he the son of Jonathan? Yes. So they sent for him. He came. And what happened? He said, everything that pertains to his grandfather saw. You know, when people in power, they accumulate a lot of wealth. So had been in power for 40 years. And his son, they had the arcades, they had everything, they had lands, even in the neighboring countries. This David said, I'm not going to revenge the blood of Saul. So what is happening? I want to show kindness to this young man, and may all the properties of his father and grandfather be given back to him. All the servants of Saul that were in the palace, be with him. And then number three, let this young man eat with me daily on the king's table. Isn't that grace? So this year, I believe, 2020 amputated our hands in terms of economy, in terms of family, in terms of health. Some people developed health issues after going through those illnesses. It's like you are incapacitated. You can't walk, you can't breathe, you can't do anything. But there is grace. As a Ugandan, and those who are listening from you all over the country, all over the world, because UBC goes all over the place, I'm urging you that do not look back. Grace is here. Grace is calling out to say, hey, come on, even though you can't walk, we shall create you artificial legs to walk again. Amazingly, people who came to see David would meet this young man. Maybe they created the oil, they formed the oil, they manufactured some artificial legs. He was able to walk. God is going to put artificial something in your life. There's special grace coming to your finances. Say amen. There's a special grace this year coming to whatever you lost. Did you lose property? Divine grace is coming. Naturally, there, I was in Rwanda 2 weeks ago, and I just felt, tell them that it's time for me to show, for it's for me to show them kindness. There are three words the Lord spoke to me, but the first one was me, from my heart, being patriotic. Number two, this word from the Lord, that it's time to peel off the past, forget the past, forget tribalism, build Uganda as a nation, but as a church, as one. Even in the Pentecostal churches, stop bickering and fighting each other, to speak as one language, because grace is here. David was able to pull this young man on the table. They were able to eat together, dine together, enjoy together. I wish you a wonderful, prosperous year, full of grace. Be ready for surprises. For Mephibosheth said, who am I? I'm a dead dog. I am a dead dog. You remember me? Maybe you think you're a dead dog, but God is going to remember you. It's a time of remembrance. It's a time of refreshing. Whatever you lost last 2020, the Lord is going to restore everything. He will resurrect our fortunes. Begin to raise your hands up. Begin to raise your head up. Love your nation. Forget the past. Forgive me. Repent about what you've done. Make a new commitment to move with God. For grace is with us. Divine grace and kindness is having our arms. May the Lord bless our country. May the Lord bless our nation. May the Lord bless our president. May the Lord bless our churches. May the Lord bless every single person. As I end, if God is showing us kindness, it's high time also to help the poor, to help those who can't afford. Those who are weak should be helped. Those who lack strength should be strengthened. God bless you, Uganda. Be a charitable nation, a country that gives, a country that gives love and smiles. May the Lord bless you. Love you so much. I'm coming from Christian Resolution Ministries International, representing the Body of Christ worldwide. And I pray that the Lord will bless you. And I wish you not just a merrier or a happier, but a prosperous, hardworking, innovative, creative year. God bless you.
It is a happy new year 2023 that God has given to us. Have you ever thought about having a blank check? Someone gives you a check and says, write any amount. I bet you will write figures that you think will fulfill all the dreams that you have. Behold, there is a blank check that has been availed to you by God. He says, write what you want. He says, restructure your life. Write your marriage on that check. Write your house on that check. Write your business on that check. Write your degree on that check. Write your visa on that check. And trust me, once the check is gone to the bank, which is owned by God, they will cash it out, and your life this year will not be the same again. Be prayerful. Work hard towards that vision that God has given you, and your life is not going to be the same again. I remain Big Sam Chisacha Munaka Jansi for your listening pleasure. May God bless you. Happy New Year 2023.